today's topic is very important, as I said yesterday. Today we are going to learn chillers. Compared to other system, this chiller offer maximum capacity, and this is for big projects like high-rise building or hospital or universities, etc. So what we'll do first, I'll show you images for air-cooled chiller. So first we'll complete air-cooled chiller, then we'll talk about water-cooled chiller. So what we'll do with the images, we'll discuss about the installation of air-cooled chiller. And if I show the installation part of air-cooled chiller, you'll get the idea, the appearance of air-cooled chiller. Then we'll talk about the components in the chiller, the primary cycle within the chiller, okay? And after that, we'll learn about the secondary cycle, chilled water cycle, okay? So this is important topic, so step by step we'll discuss. So first let me start with the basic theory, page number 35. First, basic theory, what is chiller? A chiller is a term used to describe complete chilling package that includes multiple compressors. You see, chiller offer higher capacity, so it includes multiple compressors. I'll show you this, don't worry, and multiple condensers and expansion and a single evaporator. And the evaporator type in air-cooled chiller or even in water-cooled chiller is shell and tube type. So what is shell and tube, we'll discuss in detail. Internal piping and other controls. A chiller is a machine that removes heat from a liquid via vapor compression. Already we learned vapor compression cycle, or as I said, we have one more cycle, vapor absorption. But most commonly, as I said, vapor compression, vapor absorption also we'll discuss later. In this air conditioning system, the chilled water from the chiller is distributed to heat exchanger or cooling coil in the AHU. Not only in AHU, in FCU also. So here you write in air handling unit, or in bracket you can write or FCU, because it can be AHU or it can be FCU. I think you know what is AHU and FCU. And the hot water is returned back to the chiller. So this is just a basic theory. So what I'll do, first we'll discuss the installation part of air-cooled chiller. Why directly installation part? Because with the installation part, you'll get the idea, the appearance of air-cooled chiller, and we'll talk about the components like multiple compressor, multiple condensers, etc. So here you see, yesterday we talked about AHU. And if you talk about floor-mounted AHU, the floor-mounted AHU is a big in size. No? Similarly, this chillers also is big in size. So if you talk about this big machines like floor-mounted AHU and chillers, you must install this at the initial stage of project. Initial stage of project immediately after completion of structure work. And you know what is structure? Structural includes footings, beams, column and slab. So after completion of structure work, we will install this chiller. If the project in your project, suppose if you are using chiller, so first we will install chiller and AHUs. Why? Because later you will not get the clearance to install this big machine. Suppose for example, so I'll show you the images first so that you'll get the idea why the installation of chillers and AHU, floor mounted AHU, at the initial stage of project. Initial stage means I'm not talking about design, because at present I'm talking about installation. Installation means we are talking about contacting site. So here in this image you'll get the idea. First I'll show you how the air cool appear in actual practice. So image number 23 online, and this is air cool chiller. And you see this big machine, if you install after the exterior of the building, it is difficult to handle, you'll not get the clearance. Similarly, yesterday we talked about the big AHUs, floor mounted. Suppose think that this classroom is a AHU room. And in this AHU room, I'm interested to install floor mounted AHU. So after structure work, there is no walls now. So easily the crane can pick and install in this area. Suppose after completion of brickwork, then it is difficult. You will not get the clearance. So for that reason, this machine is installed at the initial stage and covered with the plastic or any other option. And at the time of ducting or piping, we'll connect the ducting and piping to these machines or to these equipments. Okay, so we have some more important points before installing chiller. First requirement is you must wait for the structure. In this image, can you see the structure online? It's a G plus one. It's a big mall. So area is more, but the building height is, the building floor is only G plus one. So here structure work. So after completion of structure work only, we can think for installing this. And second thing, you must construct this base. Which base? Here, concrete base. So here you see. So in order to construct, so who is going to construct this concrete base? Mechanical or civil?
Civil.
You see, this depends on the scope. No doubt, the construction is done by the civil people only. But this may be depends, this may be under mechanical scope or civil. If it is under mechanical scope, means you need to hire some separate civil people and complete this task. Or else if it is in civil scope, you can coordinate with the civil people. But in order to construct this, we require dimension of this base. So how to get the dimension of this base? From where we'll get the dimension of this base? Yes, very good. Shop drawing. You already learned shop drawing, chapter 2. Shop drawing, site execution drawing. So in shop drawing, you'll find this dimension. So you must construct this. So now, and apart from this, this chiller is expensive. It is in lakhs, even in crores. And sometime we are placing order and available within the city or in country, within the country, or we can place order from other country also. It will take some time. It may take 6 months also in shipping and custom issues all. So you must order this initial stage of project. Anyhow, as a beginner, you are not going to order. But if you are working as a senior mechanical engineer in this contracting company, then your responsibility to place the order. Okay. So anyhow, this must be at the early stage, so that as per the requirement, the machine should be available on. And one more thing, this is very important. This is general information related to the decision, because you see, if you are working on site, take the decision. But before that, what are the types of decision? So first is right decision. Right decision. Second, you see, if I talk about right decision, the people will think the second type is wrong decision. But in between, we have one more, that is easy decision. So after right decision, next you write easy decision. Third, you write wrong decision. So if you are working on site and if you are thinking for installation, means the chances of wrong decision is less. But most of the people, you see, first is right decision, second is easy decision, and third is wrong decision. Wrong decision. So wrong means if you are working on site, means you have the the knowledge, so chances of taking wrong decision is less. But most of the people take easy decision. Easy decision means, for example, today's schedule for installing the chiller. So easy decision means I'm thinking just installing the chiller. I'm not thinking after installation the piping can run, and for piping the clearance is there or not. And I'm not thinking for other services. I'm not thinking for clearance for other services. I'm not going to coordinate with other service. So if you not think for overall, means you are taking easy decision. Easy decision means just temporary, just instantly. And on site, if you take easy decision, most of the time you'll find problem. For example, I'll give you a simple example. You see, as per the drawing, this is called shelling tube. The shelling tube in the drawing, it is showing at left side, because later with the shelling tube we'll connect the chill water pipe. But what you did at the time of installation, this shelling tube you install on the other side. instead of left side, the shell end tube is on the right side. So installation of chiller is done. But what happened? The piping which is going to connect from left side in the drawing, which is final, as per the site condition, considering other services, it's difficult because the pipe, the shell end tube is on the right side. And after installing this chiller, manually it is very difficult to rotate. And even if you find the problem at the end, till that time the plumbing tank and the other options, other equipment, other service equipment, if it is near to the chiller, even with the crane also we cannot rotate this. Okay, so it means that you are not thinking overall. Don't go for easy decision on site, because most of the people do this. Just they are thinking the present task, but you must think overall. You must read the drawing, and sometime error in the drawing also. Sometime error in the drawing. So you must go for planning at least one day before. If you are talking about these big machines, small machines, okay, we can reinstall, we can move, okay. In that also, if you go for right decision, that is recommended. But for big machines, you must go for the right decision. Easy decision will not help. Okay. So easy decision means quick decision and without considering the other options. So go for the right decision on site. Okay, so this will help you, and this right decision will take time. The right decision will require some additional planning, some additional time, but you will not find the problem with the coordination with the other service, and at the end you will not find the issues, because most of the time the problem you will find at the end. And at the end you'll not get the time, and at the end you'll not get the clearance also, because other services also installed. So be careful, go for the right decision on site. Okay, so this is one basic some general theory. This will help you. Next, so you see the installation. So now I'll show you the sequence of installation of chiller. So first, as I said, the structure is required and the base. So think that the base is ready, the concrete base is ready, the structure also completed, and think that the chiller also deliver on site. Okay, so now we'll do, we'll contact to this crane operators, and this kind of people we can call as other trade workers, because these people will not completely involve in the project now. They will complete the task, take that fee or that charges and move to the other work. So this kind of people we can call as other trade workers. So you must coordinate with the crane people. So at present on screen, the crane is available on site. So first, if you show the location of chiller, where you want to install to these people, according to that, first they will set crane. So these images will help you. It is in sequence. So here you see they are going to set the crane. If you closely observe here, the floor and the tire, there is a gap. Means with the hydraulics, at the time of working, the tires is not on the ground level. It is lifted. Why? Because to avoid accident in case of at the time of loading. Then here is the arm and hook. To this hook, we'll tie the belts, nylon or any high strength belts. And you see the trolley of, so here you can see the belt in image 09. After that, one minute, let me confirm. Image 09, then you see we'll tie this chiller to these belts, and slowly the engineer will coordinate to the technician, and technician will coordinate to the crane operators, and then with the coordination, slowly they will install on site. Here you can see, you see, it is already lifted. So he is guiding to the technician. Then you see with the coordination, the chiller is installed. You see, the installation of chiller is done. And here you see, after installing the chiller, in between the chiller and the base, you'll find spring isolators to reduce the vibration from the machine to the base. At present, there is no spring isolator. Next, you see in between the base and the chiller, find spring isolator. So at present, you see there is no spring isolator because just now it is installed. Na? So I'll show you the spring isolator with the other machine. So this is spring isolator. So here with the rubber pad also, and there is no direct contact between this and this component. Okay, in between you'll find this. You'll find the spring. Okay. So this is spring isolator, and this is also required, and this is also important for entry point of view. And why we learn this installation part first, because with this you got the idea about the machine component. Okay, how the machine appear, this how the chiller appear, and at present we are talking about the air cool chiller, right? Here you see. So why we did installation, because you'll get the idea about the appearance. So now we'll talk about the components inside the chiller. And inside the chiller, the cycle is called primary cycle. Talk about the primary cycle, then we'll talk about the secondary, nothing but chill water cycle. So what are the components? At the starting, we learn a multiple compressor, multiple condenser, and a single evaporator. But evaporator type is shell and tube type. Shell and tube type. So I'll show you this one first. Here image 0, here 1 2 3, 3 cabinets here, and here 3 cabinets, means total 6 compressor. At present this chiller is of 600 TR capacity, so total 6 compressors in this. Depends as per the manufacturer. It's not like that 600 TR means 6 compressor, means 100 TR 1 compressor. Depends, it may be 4 compressor of 1.150 TR. Depends. So at present multiple compressor, this 3, 6 cabinets multiple compressor, and this is electrical panel in between. And here you see this, can you see this fins here online? This fins inside you'll find the tubes. So this is condenser. So condenser 1, condenser 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, multiple condensers, multiple compressors, right? Then multiple condensers and expansion somewhere, small one, and a single shell and tube evaporator. So what is shell and tube evaporator? We'll discuss now. Here in image 0, chrome type cylinder is what? Shell and tube heat exchanger. You see, at present, in general, if you speak, this is shell and tube heat exchanger. But at present, we are using this shell and tube for as a evaporator. Na? So this is shell and tube evaporator. This shell and tube can be used in for condenser also, in water cooled chiller. Even the condenser also shell and tube. We'll discuss. Let me complete this air cool first. Because the major difference between air cool and water cool is only at condensing side. The rest of the thing is same. So if I complete this air cool chiller, then water cool easily you can understand this water cool easily. So tube. So first time we are talking about shell and tube. So I'll multiple condenser, and on the top you'll find condenser fan, right? Here you can call what condenser fans, because remember, very important point, in air cool chiller the condenser is cool by means of air, by means of outside air. And in water cooled chiller the case is different. And the major difference between air cooled and water cooled at condensing side of this is important. Anyhow, I will discuss this note in already given in your notes. So multiple compressor, multiple condenser, and a single shell and tube evaporator. So if I zoom here, see, this is shell and tube heat exchanger. In general, this is shell and tube heat exchanger, but at present we are using for evaporator. So this we can call as shell and tube evaporator. So what I'll do, I'll show you some more images of shell and tube, then we'll discuss. Here the black color shell, you see, this is a section of shell. So the outer is the black outer is shell. Inside you'll find the tubes. So what happened here, you see, for example, as per this model, refrigerant in from left side in the tube and out from right side as per this model. And if you talk about this image, in this chiller image, the refrigerant enter in from the top and flowing inside the tube and again come out from this, and water in with the yellow cap at the bottom in the shell and circulate on the coil, not in the coil, on the coil. It will means exchange the heat or reject, means the refrigerant will receive the heat and water loses the heat. And water will flow in this way, zigzag, and in the shell and come out as a chill water. And refrigerant here come out as a hot refrigerant. So in this case, in this model, water in from left and out from again from the side only. But in this image, you see water enter from the top in the shell, and you'll find the baffles, means the partitions. So water will flow up and down like this and come out as the chill water. Okay, so in the shell, so depend on model, in some model the water in from side and out from side, in some model water in from front and out from the front right only, depend whatever. So in the shell, the flow of water, in the tube, the flow of refrigerant. So that's the reason it's called shell and tube, shell and tube heat exchanger. So at present we are using as a evaporator means. So I'll show you one more image, with that we'll discuss in detail. You see, in this model, the refrigerant here, refrigerant in means chilled refrigerant in, because evaporator, na? Evaporator means the refrigerant will supply after, if it is a evaporator, at present we are taking shell and tube evaporator, na? So the refrigerant will in after expansion, so refrigerant is chilled refrigerant, na? So chilled refrigerant is in, and flowing in the tube, and what happened, here you'll find hot refrigerant out, okay, and in as what, liquid, and out as gas, you know this. So inside the tube, what, refrigerant, chill refrigerant, and here in the shell, here H2O means water in, but which water, cold water, cold water means normal temperature, cold water in and flow on the, in the shell means, so it will flow on the coil. And as per second law of thermodynamics, the water is cold and refrigerant is chill, so heat transfer from high to low, na? So water heat is given to refrigerant, the same cycle way, the water heat is given to refrigerant, and refrigerant come out as hot in the gas form, and the water come out as 2O out, so the condition is chill, cold water in, chill water out, and chill refrigerant in, hot refrigerant in gas form out, okay? And again this refrigerant by the compressor, the cycle completes, okay? But where we are supplying the chill water, that we'll discuss, that is the next cycle. But at present, primary cycle means within the chiller. Within the chiller again, the refrigerant will come out as a gas and sucked by the compressor, the primary cycle completes. But how we are going to use chill water, we'll discuss. It's in the next cycle. Means that is a secondary cycle. Okay. So in this image, water in from this bottom as cold water and out as a chill water. Okay. Same process. But how to use the chill water, we'll discuss now. Before this, this is primary cycle. So what we'll do, in your notes, find out page number 37. The line diagram is given. So here you see, in this chiller, this is primary cycle. So what do you do in this page for this drawing? You write this as what, refrigerant or primary cycle. Refrigerant or primary cycle within the chiller, multiple compressor, condensers also you can add like this. So this is the primary cycle. Now we'll talk about the secondary cycle. Okay, so the secondary cycle is what is here. This both the pipe, you can write secondary or chill water cycle. Before dealing with this secondary or chill water pipe, I'll show you the images of secondary pipe. Okay, anyhow, we have a separate module for chill water pipe designing, pump selection, fittings, accessories, etc. At present, simply we are learning how the chiller works. Okay, so I'll show you some images of secondary piping, then we'll talk about how the secondary piping works. In this chiller, you see this pipe is secondary pipe, chill water pipe. So here, image 3415. So these are number of chillers and this is completely chill water pipe. Within the chiller, primary cycle. And this pipe which is outside is secondary or chill water piping. Actually, this is with insulation. So pipe designing, pipe insulation, fittings, accessories, form selection, etc. All you'll find in module 3. So at present, simply we are learning the concept of chiller. Okay. So don't worry about the pipe designing. We'll discuss later. Now with this idea, again, go back to your line diagram. In this, I'll add some points. You can update. So you see here what happened. This is cold H2O in, right? Means in this pipe, cold water in, say 60 degree Fahrenheit, for example, standard. The range is 40 to 60, 60 degree Fahrenheit in. So cold water in and circulate on the coil and come out as a chill water. No? So this, in this pipe, you'll find chill H2O out. Say 50 degree Fahrenheit standard temperature for standard chiller. At the time of chill water piping also we are using this temperature. And you see inlet is 60, outlet is 50. So whatever delta T, 10 degree Fahrenheit. And this also standard for standard machine. So remember this, at the time of module 3 we'll use this information. For standard chiller only delta T is 10. But we have other options also. The range of delta T is 5 to 16, but standard is, for standard chiller, 10. Yaad rakhe. Here I'll put point number 1. This is point 1. See this area, same as ductable. Already we learned, so if for ductable line diagram in your notes, you can consider the same. Here detail is not added, return is not added, pressure is not, so directly given, the same as ductable. So what we learn in ductable, the same, you can consider this ductable indoor, we connected the outdoor, na? And supplying the refrigerant. But now we are not supplying the refrigerant, we are not connecting the order, we connect with the chiller. Instead of chill refrigerant, we are supplying the chill water. So this side is same, right? And you see, it can be FC also, but generally for chiller, you write AHU. And here you see point number 1. So in secondary cycle, the chill water start from the chiller with the chill water piping and supplied to the evaporator of AHU or FCU. Okay, so this I am writing point number 2. The outlet I am considering point number 3 of chiller, of AHU, and the inlet of chiller I am considering point number 4. Okay, so here I am writing the information of these points. Point 2 is what? CHW what? S. So in bracket, first you write 1 to 2 and hyphen CHWS in bracket, right? Chill water supply. CHWS means chill water supply. So chill water supply. And point 2 to 3. Dekho, yahan tak chill water yahan se start ho raha, it is supplying to the evaporative coil of AHU or FCU. You'll find the evaporator in the chiller. And this is shell and tube type. And one more evaporator in the AHU or FCU. That is normal coil type. Coil and fins. So chill water in, and you see that when the chill water is flowing here, you know what happened. You'll find the blower, filter, etc. So the air suck and filter and touches to this cool chill water coil and come out as a cool air. And the water receive the heat from the air and come out as increase in temperature. So the water is not so hot or it is not in gas. So we are not calling hot water return, we are calling chill water return only. Okay. So point 3 to point 4, point 3 to point 4 is CHWR. You can write chilled water return. And at present, on screen, the chiller is connected to only one AHU, just for learning. But in actual practice, this pipe will continue and can connect to multiple FCUs and AHUs in the building, like as per the capacity of chiller. And as per the complete circuit route, the total length of pipe considering all will go for selecting this pump as per the capacity required. So don't think that the chiller is connected to only one AHU. It can connect to multiple HCUs and AHUs as per the requirement and as per the capacity, and based on the total length, total pressure drop will select the pump. And we have a separate topic for pump selection, and this pump you can write chill water pump. And this pump at present you can write primary. And what is primary and secondary we'll discuss at the time of selecting, at the time of pump selection. At present just we are learning how the chiller system works. So we have a detailed topic about pump selection. So at present it's a chill water pump primary. What is secondary we'll discuss later. So you see the water suck again supply. The cycle continues. This way we are supplying the chill water. So we talk about the difference between DX and chill water system. In DX system directly refrigerant is responsible to cool the air. But in chill water system the refrigerant is responsible to cool the water, and the water is responsible to cool the air. This is about the chill water, the secondary cycle. Nothing but chill water cycle, right? You can write, anyhow we have a separate topic for pipe insulation, so you write insulation. One point we discussed from the starting of chapter 5, right from window to VRF. Running cost of this window split ductable is higher than chiller, right? We learn repeatedly for all them. So now we can discuss why the running cost is less in chiller compared to other system. One question to all, you see, because of this using water as a secondary refrigerant or with this chill water cycle, the running cost will decrease 60 to 70%. But how? Any idea? Online or classroom? DX system. So the reason is here, you see, in other machines directly refrigerant we are supplying to the indoor, and you see, and in this chill water system we are supplying the water. So if you compare refrigerant with water, for refrigerant it changes phase from gas to liquid and liquid to gas, and for refrigerant we required compression, and for refrigerant we required compressor for compression, and for water the water remain water only in the cycle, right? And there is no change of phase and there is no compression. So water required only circulation, but refrigerant required compression. And again the compression capacity, this high capacity, high compression capacity is required to compress the refrigerant compared with the circulation of water. For example, if I supply the refrigerant from the chiller to from this unit to the indoor, suppose my requirement is 10 HP compressor. Directly I'm supplying the refrigerant from in outdoor to indoor. But in case if I use water to circulate, I may require 3 to 4 HP pump only. So you see, 10 HP compared with the 4 HP pump, the running cost decreases almost 60%. Main reason. So because water we are circulating, we are not compressing the water. But refrigerant we require compression. And again we have a density difference of refrigerant, the property of refrigerant is different. But water remain water only in the cycle, the water will not change the phase. So water we are doing circulation. For circulation less pump capacity is required compared to the compression of refrigerant. So because of this reason the refrigerant, this chilled water system running cost is less compared to the DX system. But no doubt the initial cost is high, the initial cost is almost double or more than that. But this is mostly this chiller is for big project. Big project means the client can bear that cost. But monthly bills are reducing now, and with the reduction in monthly bill we can get the payback period. For example, system say for example 5 crores, chill water system say 7 crores or 10 crores, okay? And yearly saving with the chill water system, say suppose chiller cost say 1 crore, okay? And DX system, this is 1 crore for chiller. And DX system say 70 lakhs. This is for DX system. Okay. For the same capacity, initial cost. But in chiller, suppose yearly saving with the chiller compared to DX system is almost 60% or 60 plus. So yearly saving say 10 lakhs in energy. Because 60% reduction in the monthly bill compared to DX, so yearly savings say 10 lakhs. So this 70 lakhs and 1 crore, So 30 lakhs is extra for the chiller, na? And this 30 lakhs will cover in how many years? 3 years. So this 3 year, so this 3 years we can call as payback period. Payback period. So after this payback period, and minimum life of the chiller is not less than 10 years. So 3 years we are getting the payback, na? How much extra is recovering? So for minimum next seven years, the saving, na? Saving of 10 lakhs means 70 lakhs of saving. If you consider minimum also, the chiller life is more than 10 years, but minimum if I can consider 10 years. Okay. So initial cost is high, but running cost is less. But only this payback period will, you see, for example, the life of the chiller is 7 years and the payback period is the life of the chiller is 10 years and the payback period is 7 years. In that case, it is not considerable. Okay. Because again, maintenance and all will increase. So chiller we are using where the usage is high for big project. And if the usage is high, means saving also high, right? And the payback period will reduce and you'll get the overall saving and running cost. So that's the reason for big projects, for like high-rise building, for campus, universities, airports, etc. You'll find the chillers, okay? Because if the usage is limited, means the monthly bill saving also less and the payback is going to increase and maybe equal to the life of the system, then no use. Okay, so you must think for overall, not just initial or running cost. Okay, so this is about air-cooled chiller. Yeah. But we have some more points to discuss. Can I raise this? Pipe, no? The metal for this pipe is MS or BS, black steel. Mild steel or black steel of schedule 40. Just make a note, this schedule 40 is a class of pipe. We'll discuss at the time of module 3. At present, just for information. So the metal for this chill water pipe is black steel or mild steel of schedule 40. Schedule refers to the class of the pipe. We'll discuss in module 3. Today is this. So we have some more important points to discuss about air cool. Here, this is interview point of view. You see, air cool chiller, what I explained, you can read this, the mechanism, because, but before this, page number 35, we have some important note. Here you see, and this is interview question. The first interview question related to chiller. You do one thing, make a list of interview questions for chiller, because this topic is important. In your notes or in your diary, please make a note of important chill water system questions. The first question is, what is chill water system? Second question, draw chill water cycle and explain. Draw chill water cycle and explain. Third question you can write, types of chillers. If the question is type of chiller, means by default they are asking as per the type of condenser, yeah, water air cooler and water cool. They ask type of chiller, means they are asking as per the condenser only. If they mention types of chiller as per compressor, means that question is different. As per the compressor means we have reciprocating compressor, air cooled chiller, then scroll compressor, list of compressor. As a mechanical, I think you know types of compressor. Anyhow, the list is given. In interview, if they ask type of chiller, means they are talking as per the condenser, not as per the compressor. Compressor means they will mention. So here, very important point. So types of chiller is air cooled and water cooled as per the condenser. The next question you can write, that they will ask the difference between air cooled and water cooled chiller. This is important question. So types of chiller is air cool and water cool. Next question, difference between air cool and water cool chiller. So many people do mistake at this in this question. If they ask difference between air cool and water cool, they said in air cool air is used, in water cool water is used, with the common sense. But always common sense will not help. So the major difference between air cool and water cool is, here you see, in air cool chiller, the condensing unit, you must add the condensing unit, because the major difference is only at condensing site. Okay. So in air cooled chiller, the condensing unit is cooled by atmospheric air by means of condenser fan. This point already you know, na? Already we learn about air cooled chiller, and you know the condenser is cooled by air. Right, online? So you must, because in air cooled or water cooled chiller, in both you will find chill water cycle. And after learning also people have confusion. In air cooled they think that air is flowing in the pipe or something. In water cooled water is flowing. No. In air cooled chiller or in water cooled chiller, in both you'll find chill water cycle. The difference only at the condensing side. In air cooled chiller, condensing unit is cooled by air. You know this. But in water cooled chiller, the condensing unit is cooled by water and the water is cooled by means of cooling tower. This we'll discuss. After this, let me complete the air cooled chiller. So the major difference only at condensing side na? Right, so this is important question. Okay. Next, the next question. Application of air cooled chiller. Air cooled chiller. So now we'll discuss. Application is given in your notes. Find out page number 36 and highlight this application. This is important. So here you see the application. Air cooled chiller are most commonly used for high-rise building. Why high-rise building? Because the reason also given, you see, as the chiller are placed on the rooftop of the high rise building, because at high altitudes means high height, the wind velocity also high. An air cooled chiller cool the condenser by means of air, na? And on the height you'll find the higher wind velocity. So whenever the hot air reject from the condenser, it'll replace with a new cool air. So that you can expect the efficiency in condensation. And efficiency in condensation, you can expect the efficiency in cooling. So here you see, the wind velocity also high. This can pick up the heat of the condensing unit quick. So it not mean that this air cooled chiller is banned on low rise building. It's not like that. But recommended on the high rise building. And you see in Gulf, even for low rise building, find air cooled chiller. Why? Because for water cooled chiller, we require continuous supply of potable water. So in Gulf, scarcity of potable water, the water which is safe for drinking or cooking or taking bath is potable water. Means normal water, not hard water, means soft water. So the scarcity of salt water in Gulf, again the water is available, the Arabian Sea is connected, but that is hard water. If you use that, will corrode the metal within no time. So because of scarcity of water in Gulf, even for low rise building you will find air cooled chiller. Right, but recommended air cooled chiller is not high rise building. But if you don't have option for water cooled chiller, the scarcity of water, because continuous supply of water is required for water cooled chiller. So we'll discuss in the next water cooled chiller. So even for low rise building you will find air cooled. Application, this application also important for interview point of view. We'll talk about water cooled chiller. Here first I'll show you the image how the water cooled chiller in actual practice. Then with the line diagram we'll discuss. So here you see in your notes the appearance of water cooled chiller, or else I'll show you some more images. Here you see, this is water cooled chiller. It looks like a complicated machine, right? Air cooled chiller is a cabinet, in there you'll find the components, but water cooled chiller is like a robust or a complicated machine. I'll show you one more image with the piping connected, with the connected piping. Here this complete means present this water cooled, this is water cooled chiller, and water cooled chiller also connected to cooling tower. So cooling tower we are placing outside. Why the need of cooling tower we'll discuss, but at present cooling tower is placed outside, we cannot place inside. But this complete water cooled chiller, complete means this unit, so this water cooled chiller we can place inside the building. Air cooled we cannot place inside the building, it must be outside only. Okay, because of rejection of, or because of condensation of condensation by using outside air. But this this air water cooled chiller completely inside the inside the building. And this area we can call plant room or machine room. Yes, plant room, or it may be any floor. As per the approval by architect or interior or client, means inside the building. Okay. So here, and this area we can call plant room or machine. So here in this chiller you'll find two shell and tube, right? You see multiple compressor 1 and 2 with a high capacity. So multiple compressor, but even the condenser also shell and tube. So can you find out the two shell and tube on screen online? One is black color and one is gray color. Two shell and tube, na? Now can you identify which is condenser and which is evaporator? Or else I'll ask the question, can you identify the evaporator in this two? Online people can click on evaporator. The correct answer is black, because you see evaporator means inside you'll find the cooling, na? So black means this is with insulation. First reason, this is with insulation. So you say evaporated. And second reason, you see, after compressor, the pipe is connected to this chilling tube. So this is condenser, na? Because after compression, the refrigerant will supply to condenser. So yahan dekho, compressor ke baad ye pipe kahan ja raha? Isko ja raha na? To ye condenser raha, to ye evaporated. So this is so two chilling tube. One is condenser, the below is condenser, and the above is evaporator. And evaporator, you see, the pipe is connected, cold water in, chill water out. And where we are supplying the chill water, you know, right, in the AHU. So this cycle is same as air cooled chiller. So in air cooled chiller, we are getting the chill water. In water cooled chiller also, we are getting the chill water. So don't confuse. The difference is, in air cooled chiller, the condenser we cool with the air, outside air. Now in water cooled chiller, you see the condenser is chilling tube. The green color is a new circuit. This is hot water circuit or condenser circuit. So in this condenser circuit, below the cold water in, and in the condenser refrigerant is hot state, na? So the heat of the refrigerant will absorb by the water. So cold water in and hot water out, and refrigerant in as gas with a high temperature and out as liquid, right? So what we are doing, we are cooling the condenser with the water. So that's the reason it's a water cooled chiller. So cold water in and hot water out. Again, in order to use that water again, you must cool the water. So that water we can cool by using a cooling tower, the one with one more cycle. So this green color cycle is condenser or this hot water cycle, or at present condenser cycle. So condenser cycle also will have the pump and connected to the cooling tower. So cooling tower, I'll show you the cooling tower now. Red color pipes. See, this equipment is cooling tower. The hot water is supplying from the top, you see, here and here, and it will supply in a sprinkler form. Here the fins, so it will supply in the sprinkler form, and when this fan operate, this fan will suck the air from these fins. So this fan is used to take the hot vapor from the water out, because with the air the hot vapor also collected and throw out. So what we are doing, we are throwing the hot vapor from the water, na? And when the air passes through this water, the air also take the heat from the water. Evaporative cooling. And at the bottom you will get the collection of cool water, and that cool water again we are supplying to the shell and tube condenser to cool the condenser. Fine. So here you see one more image. This hot water in from the condenser, means from the water cooled condenser, supply in the sprinkler form. And this fan will operate and it will suck the air from here, and in between it will take the hot vapor and also cool the water. So the water collect, the cool water collected at the bottom, and this water will supply back to the shell and tube condenser, right? Following online. So the same thing we'll discuss with the line diagram from your notes. And you see, page, find out page number 38. In page number 38, you see what I did when I prepared the line diagram of air cooled chiller in AutoCAD. Same drawing I modified to water cooled chiller. So that's the reason, again, this chiller is like a cabinet, but in actual practice the appearance, you know, which is given above. So don't confuse with this. Actually I modified the same drawing to water cooled chiller in CAD. So this will look like a cabinet, but there is no fans, na? So but two shell and tube, so the actual appearance is above. So here this two shell and tube. So if I draw the line here, partition line, this side is 100% same as air cooled, air cooled chiller, so chill water cycle. And inside the chiller also primary cycle is same, but the new thing is shell and tube condenser also shell and tube. So the new circuit is what, here you can write condenser cycle. And here in this, what cold, H2O in, right? And here hot, H2O out, hot H2O out, right? And the water is responsible to cool the refrigerant, means condenser. So it's a water cooled chiller. Again, the hot water is supplying to the cooling tower in the sprinkler form, and the air will suck with these passages, and here is the fan, this cooling tower fan, and it will continuously separate the hot vapor from the water, and the cool water collected at the bottom, and the cool water again supplied to the shell and tube condenser. And you see, continuously we are taking the hot vapor out, so the level of water will decrease. It will also connect with the makeup water tank. So that's the reason I said, for water cooled chiller we require continuous supply of water. In case of scarcity of water, we cannot go for water cooled chiller. Even for low rise building, we can go for high rise build. We can go for air cooled chiller, like in Gulf. Okay, next. So we'll talk about the application of water cooled chiller. Then in next class, we'll do the comparison of air cooled and water cooled. Okay. And after comparison, we'll start the designing. In next class only. So let me complete the application. So application also important again in water cooled chiller, page number 37. What application of water cooled chiller? So 37 application of water cooled chiller, highlight this. An application of water cooled chiller is low rise building, and the best example for water cooled chiller is airports, because airport cannot be high rise, or near the airport also they will not give the permission for high rise building. So the best example of water cooled chiller application is airports or campus. University is also not high rise building, even hospital also aspect standard not high rise, camper, this laboratories, industries also not high rise. So these are few example for water cooled chiller application. Okay. Malls we can, okay, as per the height of the building, we can take air cool or water cool, but it's not strictly low rise means water cool, high rise means air cool. We have other points to discuss. We'll do the comparison. In the comparison we have some more points to discuss. So we cannot say air cool is best or water cool is best. That depends on cause, that depends on outside ambient maximum temperature, that depends on the part load or the full load usage, that also depends on type of compressor, then maintenance. We have list of points to discuss. Then if number of points suits as per the site condition or requirement, in that case we can say that particular system is best for this project. Okay, so that depends on other parameter also. Okay, but if you compare air cool and water cool only as equipment, not considering the site condition, okay, I'm comparing just air cool and water cool as a equipment or as a machine, I'm not considering the site condition, in that case water cooled chiller efficiency is higher. But why this point also, this reason also we'll discuss in next class. Follow this is very, very important topic. And again you see why this is important, because at the time of chill water piping, pipe designing, pump selection, fittings and accessories, machine selection, in all that, in all this topic you'll find this chiller. Okay, so end of today's session.